Hello friends, this is Ratwing, and maybe this is the number 8 take of my video, and welcome back. And many of you are wondering where I was. Well, someone told me,
enjoy the taste of despair.
So I obeyed and I kind of liked it.
So trusted you.
So today in this video, we will be talking about what if Free Fire wasn't made by Garena, it was made by Supercell. Yes, this idea is not particularly unique, but what can I say, nobody has covered it anyways, so I am doing it and my video is inspired, not copied, inspired by Jaso. Yeah, that's the guy who made What if Clash of Clans was made by EA or Mojang or many other companies. And the people who are thinking, what is Supercell? Who is Supercell? And why is Supercell? I must say that maybe you are not a OG gamer, so I'm gonna ignore your ignorance. In layman's term, Supercell is the company who made Clash of Clans. And well, pardon my pronunciation, I have an accent, and that accent is Indian accent. Many of you have guessed it. Well, my videos and editing aren't half bad, so if you want me to improve, then please support me. And that's it, that's the actual way to make someone improve, by supporting them or maybe hitting them, which is counterintuitive, but it works somehow. In the previous recordings, I tried to switch accents and I actually did it, but now I think that would not be good. So this is the Free Fire that was made by Supercell in my imagination. We'll call it Clash of Free Fire. Now the first thing that Clash of Free Fire and Free Fire have in difference is Clash of Free Fire. As you can see, there is gun skin, but there is no ability. I mean the attributes. Well, in actual Free Fire, in many servers, there are no gun skin attributes, which is good. And I took the good thing in Clash of Free Fire. If you wanna buy something like gun boxes or bundles or any other crates, then you can buy them. But there is a catch. There is always a catch. If you want to buy a box and open it, then you have to wait, because they have added a new mechanic in Clash of Free Fire, in which you will have to wait until the box is opened by your workshop. Yes, workshop. If you don't want to wait, use diamonds. And if you want to buy some bundles, then yeah, you also have to open bundles using the workshop. And the workshop has a working capacity. Different items or bundles would take different amount of time to open, and it would also have different amount of load on the workshop. You can upgrade the maximum load of a workshop. You will be needing actual money, I mean diamonds. Well, sometimes it feels like I talk to snakes, because when pronouncing the S consonant, I put too much pressure on it, which sometimes makes me slither tongue like Harry Potter. Coming up next, yes, now about the characters. Yes, we still have that many characters in Clash of Free Fire, but there's a catch. There is always a catch. If you want to upgrade your character or open a new skill slot for the character, you have to use the workshop. Same like the bundles and gun boxes or other items you want to open, It will also take time to upgrade your character, and it would also add a certain amount of load on your workshop. So if your workshop is not free, you can always free it up by spending diamonds. And how can you spend diamonds? You need to have diamonds at first. And how can you have diamonds? That's the same question. Well, what can I say? Money! Well, there's an old saying, time is money. And by the way, that makes an ATM machine a time machine. Well, the only reason there is no gun skin abilities in this game is because if everyone is super, then no one is super. And I want no one to be super, because if someone is super, then that's partiality or bias, whatever you call it. And there would be two kind of bundles or guns or crates you can possess. The one is being the locked one, which has not gone through the workshop yet, and the unlocked one that has gone through the workshop. Well, most of the crates that are not that big, like gun crates, would be opened in 30 seconds, and you can store the gun crates as unlocked crates in your vault. There would be two different sections in the vault of crates. And in my imagination, I have also seen that there would be a cooldown in Luck Royale. Yes, you cannot spin infinite amount of times in a day. It would be 22 times in a day, adding up all the Luck Royals, even the limited time faded wheels also. So if you have spinned in Gold Royal or Diamond Royal 2 10x spins, which is actually 11 spins, but using only 10 vouchers or the worth of 10 spin diamonds or gold, then basically you are done for that day. Else, if you want to spend some diamonds to increase your capacity for that day or week or month. And maybe many of you are thinking that it would create problem for many people. Then I missed the part, where is that my problem? And that's it, the changes in Luck Royale. So that's it for today. You can always comment on the comment section for new ideas. And I'm planning on making a part 2. So I'll see y'all in the next video. Till then, who cares?